What's going on, everybody? It's my Paul Wayne. Thank you all so much for coming back and checking out another video. And what I want to talk to you about today, Call of Duty Black Ops 3, let the good times roll. Ever since the Call of Duty Black Ops 3 beta has ended, I've been sad. Emo dive! I've been sad. I've been down. I've been randomly wandering around the house, not knowing what to do with myself, sitting down, rocking back and forth on my chair like a crazy person, just randomly getting my poo and just smearing it on the walls. I went and bought a chicken and shaved it. I called it Harry and it wears a crown. I've missed the Black Ops 3 beta like a prepubescent teenager misses that dickhead out of that band direction, whatever they're called. I just wanted to walk into random high schools, even at 24 years of age. Just go into a random high school like a zombie and just get a pen and engrave violently onto a desk. Bare hearts, Black Ops 3 over and over and over again till authorities have to come and take me away. I miss it. I miss it so much. The Black Ops 3 beta is something the Call of Duty community has been crying out for a very, very freaking long time. And we had it, and it was awesome. It was. I played it until my thumbs went raw. Literally, they were just stumps with a nail. Oh, they'll always like that. But still, I played so much of the beta when it was out. And when I was playing it, I genuinely thought at the time, like, this is what we've been crying out for. It's got the Call of Duty feel, but it's got changes. And I think that everybody gets really melodramatic about Call of Duty. Oh, Call of Duty's dead. It's been dying. It's not been a good Call of Duty since COD. Blah, 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 blah. Shut the fuck up. But I think they've actually nailed it. I genuinely do. Look, I'm going to be a glass half full kind of person. Yes, there's going to be patches. Yes, there's going to be differences when the game gets released from the beta version. But this has been by far the best Call of Duty we've had since Black Ops 2. Yes, Black Ops 2 is infested with snipers and quickscope bullshit. But I grinded so hard in that game. I hit Master Prestige more than once. I got all my guns to diamond. I had a vajazzled PDW. And even though I defend Call of Duty Ghosts for saying, you know what, I think it's actually a good game, I've never wanted to play it as much as I played Black Ops 2. I was never determined to get to Master Prestige. I was never bothered about having a golden honey badger. And I didn't want to earn a ghillie suit. I didn't care that much. And Call of Duty Advanced Warfare, look, the less I say about that, the better. That game just wasn't for me. I'm excited for Black Ops 3, and I want all the naysayers right now to shut the fuck up. Don't rain on my parade. Because we've had the beta. That's the great thing about Call of Duty this year. All the haters, all the naysayers when it comes to Call of Duty, people hating on it because it's cool, even though they play the fuck out of the game, they just like to bit jump because they get the little subscribers going, yeah, we hate Call of Duty too. They can't do that this year because they've had a beta, they've had a chance to buy it. So therefore, if you don't like the game, you're not going to buy it and you're going to shut the fuck up and do something else. Play a game you like to play instead of hating on one that everybody else is enjoying. That's one thing that I'm looking forward to. So you've had your beta, so you're going to have all the haters out there. I hate Call of Duty. Let's get the pitchforks and go charge to Activision. Yeah, they're going to be piped down. You've had the beta. You've already had time to decide whether you like the game or not. That's one reason why I'm excited. Another reason why I think I'm really freaking losing my shit over this is because the DLC, admittedly, look, I like it to all come out at the same time, but I'm really friggin' stoked that it's coming to PS4 first because so many more people have a PlayStation 4 over the Xbox One. Yes, I know the Xbox One's sounding great. Yes, it's a great console. I'm by console. I have both. But the PlayStation 4 is sold like hotcakes, whereas the Xbox One's just sold like an asbestos prostitute. And I think so many more people are going to buy the map packs. The DLC is going to be worth playing again because I like Ghosts, like Advanced Warfare. The maps, the DLC maps, you've had like a really small like bunch of the player base has been really small. Whereas, you know, you can get your Black Ops 3 PlayStation with the season pass thrown in. That's going to make even more people buy it. Just the novelty, the fact that it's on the PlayStation 4 first will make PlayStation owners want to go out there and get the map packs and get the season passes. That's another reason why I'm excited. This game is going to have so much longevity, way past the 12-month sell-by date, which Activision gives Call of Duty. Even when the next Infinity Ward game comes out, which I personally think Infinity Ward are going to learn the lessons from Ghosts and and make a far better game this time around. Look, that's something for way in the future. But even when Black Ops 3 sell by date is up and the life cycle ends, I still think there's going to be so much more to do with Black Ops 3 that this game is going to run for a really long time comfortably. And that's something that gets me excited, the longevity of the game, how much fun I had in the beta, and how much I really think that, even though, like I say, the YouTube community at the minute, everyone's bitching and saying that bigger YouTubers are taking their spotlight and their coverage and all that shit. Look, when it comes to bigger YouTubers, I always kind of think it's pathetic when a smaller YouTuber hates on the bigger one just because they have more subs, viewers, and likes and all the rest of it. Everybody starts with zero subs. I just want to put my 2 pence on there on that. Just because, look, for any small channels out there, don't go hating on bigger YouTubers and just being bitter and sour about things. Look, they got to the top for a reason. I don't care who they sucked off, how they sucked them off, and if they swallowed or spat. You know, they've got their subs for a reason. Just leave it be. Go do your own thing. But Black Ops 3, it's what, about a month away, just over a month away. I couldn't be more excited about this game. I really can't, you know. I think the Call of Duty community is going to really band together with this. And look, let's face it, it's not. It's fucking poison. I'd like to think that everybody's going to band together on this as I get twatted over the head. And like pull together and root for what a great game that this is going to be. Call of Duty is not dying. It is not dead. It's had a hangover. That's all it's had. Black Ops 2 was a massive piss up, and we spent the last 2 years just realizing the bill receipt and saying, what the fuck did I do last night? That's all that's been happening with Call of Duty. Black Ops 3 is nearly here. I'm excited for it. Let the good times roll. Cue the outro.